getting to know from the textbook, so that will be get done by the other set of people. So only to God, worshipping, prayers, and the love, and that will be going to get passed to the other people. So what if where this night of Holy Spirit will get celebrated means? It will be get done place called Dharga. So what is Dharga means? The Sufi saint person, where he has been buried, so on the dome of the Sufi saint, place of the Dharga is being get constructed. So that place is known as Dharga and belongs to the Sufi saint person. Sufi saint person means existing in the Sufism, and Sufism means purity at the same time, experiencing the God and to complete devotion to the God. They involve themselves completely about God, meditation, dance, like that's a day we don't know, doing the dance, incarnation, so all will be going to get happen. So similarly, Oras or anniversaries of Muslim saints who lie buried in various parts of the state are celebrated. People visit the Dharga with large number, offer flowers, chadars, sheets on the grave, and listen to the sayings of Kavali. They believe that they will receive the barakat or the blessings of peer or saint. People who see some specific blessings like children or job, etc., come to the Dharga and pray there. Dharga is generally built on tombs of the Sufi saints who propagated Sufism. The tomb of Dharga of Sufi saint became a place of pilgrimage to which thousands of people of all faith throng. Often, people attribute Sufi masters with miraculous power, karamats, that would relieve others of their illness and troubles. So basically, as I said, Urus means the anniversaries of Sufi saints. Sufi saints, they will be belong to the term of Sufism. They believe in the correcting and purity and experiencing the God. And these Sufi saints, when they have been buried, so that top, on the top, the construction of the place is being called as Dharga of the Sufi saints. And the people, they believe that if we these Sufi saints, because they have been connecting with the God, they will get to know what it will be. They will have prosperity to cure any kind of problems what we have been suffering of. So in this way, the people will offer the flowers on the top of the Sufi saint person, and at the same time they will offer the chadar. Means it will be like sheets, it will be the yellow color, red color, green color. So basically mostly this three colors it will be get used, red, green and yellow. So that will be get covered and of the Sufi saint, and at the same time the flowers will be offered. And sometimes they will be going with the singing of the Kavali's occasion, and the people of whom we treat are known as the saint person or peers. In this way, this Sufism has been emerged, and not only the people from different parts of the world, at the same time in India also it is existing in different parts. Likewise, this has been in the also Sufism. So Sufi saints are very famous from the North India part and to the South India part, like Gulbarga, then next to the Delhi, this is Vinoria, Ajmer. So all these have been very so famous Sufis, and the Sufi saints persons are being existing. And it is been believed that it has some special miraculous power so that our problems will be get cured. So above this also, we have been getting to know one of the Dharga which is being here is Jangirpir Dharga. One of the case study like how this Urus celebrations are we going to be get him. So the Jangirpir Dharga, where it is been located here is, it is been located in Mehboob Nagar. sitting and doing the meditation, propagating the sophism all. So by the time the habit expand, so they only that place the habit get by. The people of these two brothers who are the followers, when these sophistic person has been buried, only connected with a small type of shrine, this one like the place to protect their grave, the tomb, and the people they started worshiping. So by 16th century, Aurangzeb, the Mughal emperor, when he came to by visiting or to move my like for a war, any kind of purpose, when he happened get to know about this two brothers, Seth or something, and say Burhanuddin. When he came to know Aurangzeb about these two brothers and holiness, these persons like their powers, their miraculous powers, how much they have been dedicated, what type of things. So all when this Aurangzeb Mughal emperor came to know about this one, he appointed a person called Ibrahim as a Qazi. Qazi means to take over the part, to look after the Darga. To basically the person he will be appointed to look after the Darga. What to do, how it is being carried out, what need to do, all the take care of the Darga. So this Qazi Ibrahim, what he did was he started developing this Sufi saints talk in an elaborate manner. So likewise, it has became a place of pilgrimage. Pilgrimage is the place where the people from different sections of the people will come and offer the prayers and seek the blessings. So every day, numerous visitors around Hyderabad visit this Darga. Devotees from different states visit on Thursdays and Sundays when special offerings are made. So basically, not only just from the people of Hyderabad will be visiting, especially on the occasions like will be on Sunday, generally it will be a holiday. But whereas Thursdays, Friday, Monday, so these are the little auspicious dates when coming into consideration. So the people used to visit, I mean, 100 in numbers every day. And the special offerings are also being made to give to people as a tabaduk where the people will be coming and visiting up. Every year, annual or celebration held for the 3 days begins on Thursday, coming after Sankranti festival. Offerings of sandalwood paste, Gandhapu Puja on the first day, offering of lights, Deeparadhana on the second day, and Havani program on the third day. Visitors, as I've been saying, the visitors are not from only Hyderabad. Visitors are from different parts of the country and at the same time different parts of the country also. From not only of our country, from other countries also people will be coming and visiting out this place. So likewise, every year this both the brothers they will be do on the anniversary celebration. So the very important going to happen is after Sankranti, is basically in the January month, the very first Thursday after this the Sankranti, according to the lunar calendar things, it will be get done. So it will be a 3-day festival. So this Ola's anniversary, the celebrations, it will be of the 3 days occasions. So 3 days it will be get celebrated. In this 3 days, the first day it will be of offerings of the sandalwood paste. Then third day it will be of religions offer flowers, trees and showers. This sometimes has become a symbol of religious tolerance. So I mean, sir, this is not about the about complete of India from Hyderabad. Even the people from Hyderabad, from other districts, other states in the common listening, but at the time of this, what is celebrations of these three of origin, not only from our state, not only from our country, the people from different countries, from abroad also the people will be attending the listening. This occasions like celebrations at the time of this, the people will be going to attend. So when this is about the not completely for the Muslim or the people of Islam, they will be visiting, but the people will from other religion like Christian people, means the people who will be having the faith, who will be having the belief that if you visit to that particular shrine or the Durga, problems will be get solved, it will be get cured. So likewise, the people from irrespective of the own religion, the different people from different religions, they will be visiting all the place. So this is as to become a religious tolerance. Tolerance is with all the can be existing together. So what if the people will come, they will offer the flowers, they will be offered the sweets, or else they will be offering the chakras, the sheep, the complete sheep on the grave, as I've been saying, in the three colors. Or else sometimes the people, if they had any kind of wish, if the wish has been get fulfilled, of any thing, so they will be doing the sacrificing of the animal, and at the time they will do this, like a kind of small get together near to that particular Sufi saint. So in this way, the celebration seems to be get carried out. So the next class we will be going to deal about the Bonalu, one more the religious folk daily celebration, and then still the next two more the antiquity of folk traditions, intermixing, what is the mixing of the religions, so all this will be going to deal in the lectures. So apart from these two topics, what is it here, what is born and how it is being celebrated, and next we coming to this for celebrations, how those celebrations is being get done, on what base, how it will be get done, so where this Shantipur Durga is existed, how it is been creating the religious order.